congratulations, sending you lots of love virtually, even though we can't celebrate with you in person. Stacy, we haven't met yet, but I'm hopefully that will change once everything has calmed down a little bit. Let's see, my favorite thing about Stacy and Neil definitely is the Instagram quality. It really sets the bar high for the humor for me, giving me something to strive for. Absolutely. lots of love to you both. Congratulations, and I can't wait to celebrate and see you in person.
Happy wedding day, Stacy and Neil. I'm so excited for your future together. One of the many ways that you've inspired me is the way that you travel together. Mark Twain once said that there's no surer way of finding out whether you like someone or hate them than to travel with them. Well, you two have certainly put traveling to the test. I can remember the first road trip you were planning, and I asked Stacy, does he know not to talk to you first thing in the morning? And to which she replied, yeah, or he will. Well, I love the way that you plan together and share your journey of museums, landscapes, fun photos, food, and so much more. Marriage is definitely a journey full of twists and turns. Well, if traveling together is any indication of success, then you two should do well. So excited for you. Happy wedding day. I love you so much.
Hey guys. So I've known Stacy almost 29 years. From growing up heights together to being stupid teenagers to living together in college for a year. Somehow in all of this, we haven't killed each other. There have been a lot of highs and lows. We have been through a lot of stuff, but somehow we have remained friends, which is awesome. But I got to see a new side of her whenever you guys came to San Antonio. It was really fun to see how Stacy just lit up when Neil would walk back in. It was fun to see how well you guys fit, how happy you made each other. So I'm really, really excited you guys are getting married. Congratulations. I'm so sorry none of us could be there, but you guys literally have the rest of your lives to spend together. So we are going to celebrate when all of this stuff is over. I'm going to celebrate you guys, but until then, enjoy your wedding day. Go have a blast, go have fun, because you guys are getting married. And we will be celebrating you and supporting you from Texas. Congratulations!
Neil Wampus, Stacy Wampus, Mr. and Mrs. Paul Wampus, happy wedding day! One can't think of you two without also thinking of pizza. Neil, our story of pizza begins long ago, back when our family had the never-ending debate over which was better, Gennari's $5 pizza or Giuseppe's actually good pizza. And if I recall correctly, which I usually do, there was a time that you favored Gennari's bland, doughy pie to the actually good, flavorful, chewy Giuseppe's pizza. Stacy, thank you for introducing him to good food, among other things. You know, you and I have found pizza to be such an important part of our life that when you sent a press release to me to announce your relationship with Stacy, you found it necessary to also announce that she has the very important but oft underlooked skill of ordering pizza for a group. Stacy, one of the other first things Neil told me about you was that you had been to Pizzeria Badia. When I was on maternity leave, I heard an NPR interview with Joe, and trying his pizza had become this mythical event that I was trying to do in my life. Thankfully, you two took me to the OG Badia before it closed that year for my birthday. Since then, we've spent countless hours talking about making and eating pizza. In fact, the last thing we did before the quarantine was eat pizza good together. Sometimes someone comes into your life and you know immediately that they're going to be there forever. Stacy, I think I can speak for my entire family when I say that we knew that about you when we met you. No one knew better than Molly, who gave you a kiss on the lips the first time she met you. I know this wasn't the wedding day you had planned, but I hope that you're able to find an intimate and special day nonetheless. Cheers, happy wedding, and here's to many more rolls of pizza.
Neil and Stacy.
Congratulations!
We're so happy for you guys, and it's very considerate that the reception is happening in our living room.
I know. I am even wearing a Stephen Curtis Chapman t-shirt, and I haven't washed my hair in 3 days. But seriously, congratulations. Stacy, you were the first dining car I met, and you set the bar pretty high. I'm excited to be an outsider with you, so saddle up your horses for the great adventure.
Neil and Stacy, in preparation for this toast, I couldn't quite find the right words to convey my feelings, so here are several different toasts that you guys can just choose from. Hello, for those who don't know me, my name is Aaron, I'm Neil's older brother, but we're not normal brothers, we're pretty crazy. Hello, for those who don't know me, my name is Aaron, I'm Neil's older brother, and we're actually fairly normal brothers, and this will be a pretty standard toast. When I first met Neil, he was naked and crying and had the biggest testicles I've ever seen. Neil, Stacy, mazel on your marriage. What a mitzvah this all is. Ugh, this is beautiful. Sorry, I'm getting a little verklempt. I'll see you at the bris. Neil, you might be getting married before me, but I'm still taller. Neil and Stacy, from one text to another, we couldn't be happier for you guys. We are so happy for you, and I'm so proud to be your brother, and we're so happy to celebrate with you. We can't wait to see you again. So, to Neil and Stacy.
Hi, Stacy and Neil. Happy almost wedding day. I hate that we can't all celebrate together, but what better way, Stacy, to tell you that we miss you and Helena than to film from the roof where Jenny first made her debut and scared all of our neighbors, and they would call us and say, your dog is on the roof. So I'm up here on the roof hanging out like Jenny dog. She's a little crazy, but we love her. She would go up the back apartment stairs and climb up on the roof and just hang out. It is a nice view. She's smart. Love you guys. Happy wedding day.
Hi, Neil and Stacy.
I'm sorry I couldn't see you on my birthday.
We're sad that we couldn't celebrate your wedding with you.
But we will celebrate the next time we see you. Go Pistons.
Stacy and Neil, I hope you don't get the coronavirus. Good wedding, I love you. I love you, Stacy and Neil, and I hope you have a good wedding. I hope you don't get the coronavirus. We love you.
Bonjour. Good luck. We wish we could be there with you. Hope you have a lovely little ceremony. Something you'll remember.
Hi, Neil.
Hi, Stacy. Hi, Neil. Congratulations.
Hi to Neil.
Oh.
Okay.
Start over.
Do you want to start over?
This is what 34 years come to. Congratulations on your wedding day. We are so happy for you. All the best and many happy years to come.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Weather the storm.
Yes. Congratulations, guys.
Congratulations. Bye.
Hi, Stacy and Neil. I just wanted to say congratulations. And I'm very happy and excited for both of you. And I wrote this for you. I wish for you a traveling companion to make your journey an adventure, make mountains into mere hills, to make impossible realities, to make gritty moments smooth. A traveling companion who shares your vision of the path, shares the weight of the load, shares alternative routes not seen, shares the love of finding the unknown. A traveling companion knows the journey is meant to be every moment together. The weather will always change, and detours are to be expected. And home is every step you take together. of you guys both. Congratulations.
Favorite things about Stacy and Neil are definitely hard to narrow down. First and foremost, their level of respect for Gritty, as depicted in every piece of internet content ever. Second, the warmth and lively energy that they bring into every room they're in together. And three, that they are one of few couples who you can tell, like, really get each other on a fundamental level. There might be some telepathy going on there, something we can look into, but it's awesome. And I couldn't be happier that these two people are going to end up together forever. I had the honor of being with Stacy just ahead of her first date with Neil and sent her off into battle with a mason jar full of stuffing. So I feel partially responsible for this wedding, because I think the stuffing probably had some kind of, like, attractive properties that, like, really helped things go well. But I will say that as soon as Stacy and Neil started dating more than once, Stacy had to ask for some Taylor Swift tips and tricks and came over to study the entirety of the album Reputation so that she was ready to go for conversation with Neil, which is exactly when I knew that this was the one, because any guy who you need to study Taylor Swift for is a good guy in my book. So very excited about this wedding, very excited to see all the wonderful things that they do in the future. And love them both very dearly.
Hey guys, can you say hi?
Hi.
Say hi. Hi guys. We're so happy for you and we're so sad that we won't be able to be there with you to celebrate on your special day, but we're really glad that you have each other. And we hope that it's the best day that it can be. And we hope that we can celebrate with you again sometime soon. You guys are such special people. You're so fun and unique and so great for each other. So we know that whatever the day is, it's going to be perfect.
Congratulations, guys.
Yes, congratulations.
Hi, Stacy and Neil. This is Mimi speaking for Pop Pop. We are so sorry we can't make it for your wedding. But just know our hearts and our thoughts will be with you, and we love you very much and can't wait for party time. So y'all just have a wonderful day, and just remember that the most important thing in your marriage is to love one another and always tell each other that. And hope to see you soon. Love you guys.
Hey, Stacy and Neil. Happy wedding day. It's Jean Jean, dressed in her finest drag queen and inspired garb for the big day. I wanted to say, as a couple, I hope you never cease to be amazed every day by how special you are individually and what a fabulous force you are as a couple. You guys are so special to me, and I just hope that your marriage is filled with love and laughter, and it just spills over into the rest of your lives. So you have a happy, happy day, and I can't wait to party with you guys when we get to celebrate. Love you.
Happy wedding day, Stacy and Neil. Day. We have a wedding ode for you. Today we come together to celebrate Stacy and Neil. Oh, how to put into words all the things that we feel. You two are made for each other, basically from the same mold. We can't wait to see how more of the same you are as together you grow older. You have already begun your journey of for better or worse when having to make tough decisions and have your whole wedding change course. But you took each step in stride, hand in hand through it all, and this foundation of strength you've built ensures your union will never fall. We love you both so much. This guy especially. We're so excited for the years to come of aunt and uncle memories. We're with you today in spirit and heart, and we'll always be walking with you, no matter how far we live apart. We can't wait to eat more pizza and have more Philly days. And when the big party day arrives, we can't wait to sing more of your praise. So happy wedding day to our favorite Gritty fans, to the two who know how to make some delicious lemonade out of any lemon-soaked plan. We love you.
Love you.
Give a kiss.
Mwah! Love you guys.
Hi, Neil and Stacy. It's Aunt Lori and Uncle Mike. Just wanted to wish you the best for your upcoming wedding. Wish we could be there. This is unfortunate pandemic that we're having is really hitting us all hard. I love you guys. Hope you have the best day. And Stacy, I know I haven't met you yet. I hope to meet you soon after all this is over. You guys are great. I do follow you on Facebook, and you look like you have a lot of fun together. So all in all, have a great day. Hope to see you. Hope to celebrate with you soon. Love you. Take care.
Yeah, congratulations, and best of luck to you.
Bye now.
Bye.
Hi, Neil and Stacy. We really wish that we could be with you to celebrate your special day, but I know it'll be wonderful. And I just want you to know that you guys handled this with such dignity and grace and maturity. And I know it's disappointing to you that you can't have all your family and friends there, but it's not about the day, it's about your life together. And we wish you the best.
We are with you in spirit, and we wish we could be there in person, but we can't. And so therefore, we just wish you many, many happy years together. Congratulations.
We love you.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Stacy and Neil from the Heckmans, or one of the many Heckmans. We're so happy and excited for you guys being married. And we just wanted to make this tribute video for you, along with a lot of other people.
Yeah, and Stacy, welcome to this family. It's interesting to be an in-law to all of this, but I also know that you guys, this isn't the day that you planned, but the most important thing is that you two have each other, and that is a beautiful and wonderful start to your relationship, and we'll celebrate soon.
Can't wait. Neil, you're probably one of the smartest and funniest people that I know, but you know, that goes without saying. I love talking to you and to Stacy about all the things that you guys have done. Stacy, the way that you just have jumped in, you talk to everybody when we have family gatherings, you engage everybody, and your genuine interest in what we're talking about makes you just an amazing person and so much fun to hang out with, and I can't wait to get together in person real soon. And we also, of course, wanted to say, Annalise wanted to say something to you. What did you want to say, Annalise?
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Happy wedding day, Neil and Stacy. Neil, when you were little, we used to think that you were very shy. And then we'd see you in different settings, like at School of Rock or at Rotary or with your college friends. And we came to realize that you were just very selective. When we see you with people you had chosen to be with, you are anything but shy. Now when we see you and Stacy together, you seem so natural together, so yourselves, that it's obvious that you have selected each other and belong together. It's written, when children find true love, parents find joy. Stacy, since joining our family, you have contributed to our family's joy in so many different ways. From being able to keep up with Tom and all the jokes the kids tell back and forth at the dinner table, to seeing Neil's ever-expanding palate. Long gone are the days when Dad would ask, what's for dinner? Immediately followed by, is Neil going to eat that? Granted, Neil, you had improved after you had studied abroad. But since you and Stacy have met, we've seen you have eating adventures that have been taken to a whole new level. One of the greatest joys this past Christmas was cooking the salmon and kraut and the steak tartare with both of you. Both were things that I never would have expected you to eat, Neil. Here's to your joy and ours from this day forward. Happy wedding day, Neil and Stacy.
Hey, Stacy and Neil, congratulations. Can't wait to see you guys and celebrate together.
Congratulations. We'll celebrate later when things aren't as crazy.
Cheers.
Congratulations, Stacy and Neil. In honor of the occasion, I've come up with a small poem. I call it Cadence. Here's to you, Stacy and Neil, as you tie the knot and apply the imprimatur, committing to each other while before God you get on your knees, and the mortar of your love gets the chance to solidify. We know the day's circumstances are something of a pivot, while you are constrained to the confines of the neighborhood.
while coronavirus makes our lives somewhat crappy, watch your language, rendering to null the chance of the appearance of the Flyer's mascot. Nevertheless, you are to become husband and wife, and I wish that together you have a wonderful journey, one with a minimum of trouble and conflict, and a marriage where joy flourishes and is abundant. So now the hour of your vows is nigh, but you climb to the roof to be close to the clouds. While I'm sure these words won't make you weep, although not because I didn't make an attempt, on the other hand, maybe it will make you grin some crazy words by your silly next week. Relations. Either way, I'll call it a victory if my love for you both breaks through the noise. Seeing you together brightens my heart with warmest wishes for a glorious beginning, with days as sweet as a fresh fruit galette, and years that go on where you never shall divide. So it goes without saying that I wish you the best, and of this with assurance you surely may relax. And I know there will be some days that provide a trial. Still approach each day with vigor and spice. And as the quarantine goes on, please stay sane. Fill up a flute and toast some Prosecco. And in no time at all, you'll be on a flight, Hawaii bound, as the virus does diminish. So to a perfect pair, celebrate your time. As you move through life, a couplet suddenly rhymes. Love you guys.
Hi, Stacy and Neil. We wish you the best with your upcoming wedding, and we're really sorry we can't be there and that you can't have the day that you originally planned. But we know it'll still be a beautiful day, and that you'll be, and we're happy you get to be able to celebrate your love together. And that's really what matters in all of this. So we're really excited for you guys and your marriage, and we're hoping that we can celebrate sometime in the summer or fall with you when this is all over. Best of luck. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Hey, Neil and Stacy, Henry here, as you probably surmised. I love you both very much. My favorite thing about you is that you're two of the funniest people I know. Neil, you've been my friend and been a pleasant person to chat with and have been making me cackle for now a long time. I think one of my favorite memories of you is when you, Carson, and I came up with the classic cat and lizard dichotomy on our way to Harper's Ferry, West Virginia. I try to bring it up. I also tell people about the three ghosts in all of cinema and stories, and spread the word of your wise counsel. Love you. Take care. Congratulations. I miss you both.
Hello, Neil and Stacy. Congratulations on your wedding. I'm sorry that there is a terrible lag in this video, but I hope it will be hilarious. Neil, since you have entered my life, you've got me Mr. and Mrs. Slimer, the Monster Mash, Gritty, and so many beautiful things. I've gotten to see cats in a whole new way thanks to the pictures from your bachelor party. Stacy, I have also been able to see, since you have come into our lives, that you have brought so much exploration and fun and gritty cakes and themed foods into Neil's world. And for that, I thank you forever. Congratulations, you guys. I hope you have a wonderful marriage, and I'm sure you will. Hi, this is Lily. You know that.
Okay. Hi, Stacy and Neil. You gonna say congratulations?
Congratulations.
We miss you, and we hate that we don't get to come celebrate with you, but this is a pretty cool idea. So my favorite thing about Stacy and Neil, and actually I think it's kind of the same thing about, no, I'm sorry, let me start over. How my life has been impacted. So unfortunately, I haven't got to spend a lot of time with Neil, but because Stacy loves him, excuse me, that means I love him. So you're in. There's no worries on our end. But how my life has been impacted by Stacy was really when this guy was a baby, when he was first born. Stacy just became this wonderful, supportive neighbor.
And she was always just so kind and patient. And she spent time with William while she was here. And whether he knows it or she knows it, they definitely impacted each other's lives. I'm definitely grateful that there's a piece of Stacy inside this little guy's heart. So we're saying congratulations. We have our drinks. Can you show them your Willarita? William, we both have our mocktails. We're toasting. Woo! Cheers, you guys. Have a wonderful wedding. And we will see you once all this dies down. And hopefully William can even come with me to Philadelphia. We love you.
Congratulations.
Love you. Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Stacy and Neil. I knew from the first time I saw you together that you would be good together. Can't wait to celebrate with you. Best wishes.
Congrats.
Congrats. Best wishes.
Oh, hello there. If you're watching this, then that means that you've decided to marry a Dininger. You likely have a lot of questions. Well, good news, I have answers. For the low, low price of some of the alcohol you left in my dining room, you can now purchase my new book, So You've Married a Dininger. This comprehensive guide includes everything you need to know as you join the Dininger family. It has chapters such as The Miracles of the Dininger Memory, What Does Patrick Duffy Have to Do with Dental Hygiene, and many more. Only the funniest, kindest, warmest people will be accepted into the Dininger clan. If this describes you, then this book is a must read. Don't hesitate, marry a Dininger today, live a life of laughter and warmth. Buy my book!
Dear Stacy and Neil, well, we're finally here, wedding day. Congratulations on your special day and the beginning of a new level of life together. Let me quickly say, I know this is not all that you were planning, but remember the size and the circumstances of a wedding are not indicative of the quality of the marriage. I'm proud of the decision you made to protect the health of your family and friends, but this virus and its resulting disruptions has nothing to do with the wonderful marriage you two will have together as husband and wife, partners for life. I'm celebrating the joining of my precious daughter, Stacy, to Neil, her wonderful soulmate and partner. Stacy, I know you well enough to realize that when you chose Neil, it was a commitment of your whole person to him and to your relationship. And I'm looking forward to learning more about Neil in the months and years to come. I have a lot of confidence in the vitality of this relationship for two more reasons. The first is that I've been praying for Stacy and her future mate since they were, even before they were born. This day, to me, is a fulfillment of a 29-year prayer vigil. I will continue to pray as the relationship matures and blossoms. The last reason is that when Stacy started talking about Neil, Mom and I asked the usual questions. After Stacy had answered our inquiries, I asked one more question. I said, so what does Jenny think? When Stacy said she liked him, I knew we had a winner. You see, I have a lot of confidence in the perception and discernment of my Arkansas granddaughter. After spending time with you two, it is obvious that you were meant for each other. I've seen a synergy of how you celebrate each other's strengths and work through one another's weaknesses. Your relationship reminds me of how important it is to communicate well, encourage often, and forgive frequently. I love the way you seem so comfortable around each other. Whether you're engaged in a cooking project or contest, or just sharing some space with separate books and coffee. My prayer for you is that your marriage will be a wonderful time of discovery and growth, that you might fulfill the potential God has for you in His kingdom plan, that you might forge stronger ties to family and friends now and in the future, that you might find new ways to love your neighbors and give them a voice, especially the weak, forgotten, and ignored. And finally, that you would never forget that you two are loved and cherished. We love you, sweetheart, and look forward to this new chapter in your life. God bless you.
Hi. My favorite thing about Stacy and Neil is their ability to turn just about anything into a special event, whether that's going to the grocery store, going to the pool, trying a new restaurant, going to see a movie. Everything can be special, can be fun, worth dressing up for. And so I always love getting to spend time with them. And I also really like getting to see how much they care about each other. And they let me invade their space quite a bit. And their home feels like a second home for me. And they're a huge reason why Philadelphia feels like home. So I feel very lucky to get to know them and how they've impacted my life. They're my favorite food friends. There's no one else that I would rather have dinner with. And I'm so excited for them, and I love you both.
Hi, Neil and Stacy, congratulations. I'm so sorry that we didn't get to come to your wedding, but I'm so glad, so proud of you, Neil. And I'm so happy that you met Stacy. Stacy, I hear wonderful things about you, and I can't wait to meet you in the future. And remember, stay happy, always forgive each other, and laugh a lot, and just enjoy your life together. But I hope to meet you soon. And congratulations on everything. And love to the both of you. Aunt Karen.
Hey, Neil and Stacy, congratulations. I'm just going to do my wedding speech for this, so here goes. I know I always kind of thought that Neil would be the first of us to get married, and when he started dating you, Stacy, we were all pretty sure that you were the one. Neil never really told us much about his dating life, so the fact that he actually called me to say that you guys were dating was a big hint that something big was going to happen. When I first met you, Stacy, it was immediately apparent that you guys were the right people for each other. Stacy, I really appreciate that you made me feel warm and welcome when I met you, and that we both had the same goal of being kind and open to the people that Neil cares the most about. It's been awesome to spend our New Year's together last year, for me to come see you in Philly, and for you to come see us in DC. And every time I've hung out with the two of you, it's felt super natural, and like Stacy just automatically fit right into our friend group, which I think is really, really important. I've also loved seeing both of you hashtag pushing the limits of Instagram together, spending all of this time with your families, going to the presidential libraries, wearing your matching tatties, and just getting into it. But mostly it makes me really, really happy to see you two be happy together in the way that only the two of you can, with your shared sense of humor and priorities, and the way that you two make each other grow into even better people, even though you're already really great as it is. Of course, I'm so, so excited to see your relationship continue to grow when we visit each other in Philly and DC. Maybe we'll have another vacay together in the near or far future, and who knows? Maybe we'll all move to the West Coast someday. I really miss you guys right now, but you're gonna have two kick-ass weddings, and I don't think too many people can say that. So glad that I get to celebrate you and be part of your lives. Neil, you're one of my best friends, and I just couldn't be happier for you. I love you.
Stacy and Neil, happy wedding day. We are so sad that we can't be with you to celebrate in person, but are just so happy that this day has come and you guys are one, and just wish you all the love in the world. So for our tribute today, I was thinking about the thing that I love most about both of you. Obviously, I know Stacy a little bit better, but you both have such big hearts and just live so generously with your skills and your talents. And one of my favorite memories of Stacy was watching you lead the summer reading program at the Boys and Girls Club, and just your love of reading, how you just drew kids into that program. And your love of reading was contagious for them, sort of drawing them in to the program and made it super, super fun. And then Neil, I've met you once, and the one time I met you, you were hustling all around Philadelphia trying to give folks the opportunity to vote while they were in the hospital. And so just really amazed by both of your ability to live so generously with your skills and your talent. Both of you have huge hearts and just empathy for the people in your community. So I can't wait to see what you guys do together.
Stacy and Neil, we are so excited as you continue to grow together and start off marriage together. And I just think of your contribution to your community, what gifts it is to be with people that are living life to its fullest and living deeply. And we hope to get to see you guys sometime soon, and just rejoice with you. We'll be praying for you.
Love you guys.
Hi, Neil and Stacy.
Congratulations on your wedding. Sorry we can't be there and that you had to cancel it, but we're there with you in spirit.
Congratulations.
Hi, guys. It's Grandma Marion Myers. Just wanted to wish you guys a blessed and happy married life. I hope you'll be as happy as I've been in both my marriages. God love you, and I'm glad to have been able to speak to you. Sorry I can't come to the wedding. I have my clothes and I'm all set. Talk to you later. Bye.
Hi, congratulations and have best wishes for a good life together. Sorry I can't be there. Bye.
Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married.
Of the craziness, today it's going to be perfect. It's going to be one that you'll never forget. I know that I haven't met you, Neil, yet, but I know that you are an amazing person simply because Stacy's chosen you. And as we both know, she's pretty wonderful and amazing herself. Stacy, I love you so much, and I'm so thankful for our friendship. And I love that even though we don't get to see each other all the time, we communicate with each other all the time. Every time that we do talk, we're able to pick up right where we left off, and I love that about our friendship. I love you so much, and I know that y'all's life together is going to be spectacular and wonderful, and you're going to be able to do so many fun and amazing things.
Hey, Neil and Stacy. I just wanted to say congratulations to your guys' wedding. I'm super grateful to have met you guys. You're amazing, you're so kind, and I'm so thankful that I was part of your engagement party and that I was supposed to be part of the wedding, and I'm super sad that all of that isn't happening right now. But one thing that COVID-19 cannot cancel is your guys' love for each other. And you guys are so perfect. Your relationship seems so fun. And I'm really excited to watch you guys grow as husband and wife. And I hope to see you guys very soon. Congratulations. And you guys are amazing.
Stacy and Neil. Well, hey, there was absolutely no way my wife and I were going to be able to come to Philadelphia, Lancaster. That's where it was. So I'm glad, in a maybe bad way, that I get to do this at least. But sad that you guys had to cancel, but I hope you can make the best of it. Neil, I'm sure you're a great guy. If I ever get to meet you, I would love it. I'm supposed to answer two questions, but I don't know Neil, so I can't answer the part about what's my favorite thing about you two. But I will say, Stacy, I have enjoyed all the time that we've gotten to spend chatting or talking together, and I thought you might enjoy this memory from college when we thought we were super cool and would do a ring dunk.
I wish I'd gotten
the next one. Can I try some of this?
Yeah.
Work
up a tolerance. See? That's you.
Okay. One, two, three.
Let's watch, Stacy. be cool.
Stacy, this is terrible. It's so much
fun. That's enough. Hey, well, love, best wishes to see y'all. Best wishes to you guys. And I hope you have a good life together. I have no advice for you because I don't know what I'm doing either. Bye.
Happy wedding day, Stacy.
Cheers.
Cheers. We are so excited for you both to get married today and for all the fun that I'm sure today will bring. We are sad that we can't be there with you. And as you know, Blake was preparing to give some words at the ceremony to help other people understand your relationship and get to know you both as a couple. And even though he won't be sharing that with everyone, it does feel like a special privilege that we got to know a little bit more about your relationship in the process. So he's going to share a few of his takeaways.
Thank you for that. I learned that you both love good data and that you track everything from your media consumption to your shared odd similarities. Some of the ones that I thought were interesting were that you're both middle school percussionists, you both studied German, you both had a shared interest in cows at a young age, and that you both share the hype around 2026, which I don't know what that is. But the thing I found most interesting is how committed you both are to maintaining your shared history. Speaking to both of you, I felt like I was talking to a caring librarian overseeing an important archive. And I think that's important not because documenting the history of your relationship is important, but because the way you think about each other and your relationship is important, and because the stories that we tell about the past are actually often about the present and what we hope for the future.
So we are so excited for the love and data that you will continue to share as you develop your relationship. And we love you very much, and we're really excited for 2026. Cheers.
Can't wait.
Hey, Stace and Neil. I hope you guys are having a special day together. Congratulations for your wedding. I hope that soon we can all celebrate together. You guys take care. Bye-bye.
Hey, Stacy and Neil. I just wanted to wish you guys congratulations on the wedding. Don't let the current situation get you down. You know, we're going to have an awesome time celebrating you guys' union once all this is overdone with, all right? Congratulations.
Hello, Neil and Stacy. I'm excited for your wedding on April 4th. In the meantime, here is a little video message. Neil, thank you for being an amazing friend for the last 8.5 years. And for the 4 years in which we lived together, life was always a celebration, whether we were learning new hobbies or dancing in costume. I also want to thank you for being an amazing and inspiring friend. I wouldn't be the person I am today if I didn't feel like I could come to you and tell you my ambitions and hopes and hear your thoughts as well. So thank you for never wavering and how much of a unique individual you are. That really left a wonderful imprint on me. And thank you for your brains, wittiness, and caring friendship. Stacy, I'm really excited that you and Neil have found each other. It's been a blast getting to know you and doing visits to Philadelphia and having you both visit on your road trip in California. I think it's very clear and obvious that you two make a great pair, and you have a very easy and nice way with each other, full of laughter and adventures. I also think you have a notable passion for gritty, the both of you. That's very important. Finally, when I heard about the story of you two jumping into Crater Lake together, I thought that was really special. And I think it's very clear that you have a lot of adventures and road trips ahead of you as a couple. So I hope you keep on exploring and being curious and living in the moment, in those moments. So, have a great one. I'm excited to party with everyone next year, and I will see you on April 4th. Congratulations. Bye.
Hello, friends. I am speaking to you in my own bathroom because my girlfriend is using the living room to do a puzzle, and I just wanted to tell you guys how much I love you. The prompt for this was, please leave an unforgettable gift, and I need you to fully cognate how forgettable this particular video will be. But I love you both very much. Neil, your sense of humor, I talk about it like you are like a legendary Pokemon, and they're like, what is so special about Neil? And I'm like, you don't understand. And I'll show them Instagram photos and show them captions, and they'll like kind of get it, but like not fully get it. And I go, they're not worthy. Stacy, it has been so good to only get to meet you a couple times, but I am sure we will do more of that. And that is all. But I love you both, and I will see you both soon. And if you ever want to do just a party or something, or come to Boston, I would love that very much. Okay, bye.
Hi, Neil and Stacy. It's Nora, Matt, and Marla. We just wanted to say congratulations on tying the knot. We're very happy for you and wish you all the best.
Hey, Stacy and Neil. Happy wedding day. We wish we could be there with y'all to celebrate, but we know y'all are going to have a fantastic day, and we can't wait to celebrate with y'all sometime soon. Stacy, it's been amazing to have a friend like you, you know, as far back as I can remember. And even though we've been living in different states for several years, I love that we've been able to keep in contact and stay in touch as much as we can. And you and Neil seem like a perfect combination, so I'm so excited for y'all, and we wish y'all the best.
And one of the things was, what's my favorite thing about y'all? I'll talk about Neil on this one. My favorite thing about Neil is that sick bolo tie that he wore to our wedding a couple years ago. So Neil's got a great sense of fashion. So wish you all the best, and let us know if there's ever anything we can do for y'all. I'm not ashamed as a man to say that my marriage to Sarah is the best thing that's ever happened to me. So y'all are in for a lifetime of happiness together. So congrats, and wish we could be there with y'all.
Happy wedding day, Stacy and Neil. I'm so excited for you guys, and I of course wish that I could be there in person to celebrate you and hug you, but I know that day is coming soon enough, and I know that today is gonna be so special for you, and I hope that you guys feel the love from all over the place as we are all thinking of you and celebrating you today. Stacy, when I think of the beginning of our friendship, I think about how hard it must have been for you every time I asked, what is your favorite plank? And you had to say something like, I don't have favorites. I don't rank things. Don't put that on me. And it was kind of hard for me, as someone who loves having favorites and discussing what my favorite things are, to have to respect that. And I probably should have respected it a little bit better, because I still think I asked you at least daily what your favorite whatever was. But I think I still like did a pretty good job of sneakily figuring out what your favorite things were, even if you wouldn't label them as such. What I do absolutely love about you is how you implement and celebrate the things that the people around you love. So whether it's my favorite chicken fajita roll-up from Applebee's, or my favorite bar in North America, Milk Boy, or me saying, hey, I'm obsessed with this show Parks and Rec, I think you should watch it. You do such an incredible job of folding that into your life and into the relationships with people you have. And I think that is so special and something that I absolutely love about you. I have loved seeing how that has taken shape in your relationship with Neil, and how you guys have kind of traded your favorite things or things you love back and forth, and how you have found new things together. So whether it's Taylor Swift or the Newport Folk Festival, or hiking. I love the ways that you guys have kind of adopted things from each other and then found new things together. And I do think it's safe to say that you have some favorites now. Like Gritty is probably your favorite mascot, safe to say. And I think that Neil like might be your favorite person since you are marrying him. But I'm so happy for you, and it is a 100% fact that you are one of my all-time favorite people. And I truly don't know where I would be without you, without your support, without the laughter you've provided me, without your wisdom, without our hours-long book talks on the phone. You are such an incredible, selfless, loving person and it makes me so happy to see how happy you are with Neil. And I'm so excited for you guys. I'm so excited to see where you go in the next few years and far beyond that. And I'm so happy that I've gotten to be a part of it, even from afar. I love you guys. I hope today is the best, and I can't wait to see you soon.
Hey, Stacy. Just sending you best wishes as you and Neil become one. We were so hoping to spend this time with you so that we could meet him and his family, but I truly understand, and I hope at a later date we can celebrate. And again, many blessings. We love you.
Hey guys, it's David. I love you both, and congratulations. So sad that we can't be there to celebrate you guys now, but I'm so happy for you both. Congratulations. It is such a thrill to see you both so happy. I'll never forget getting to run around with Neil and do the Monster Mash and Cupid Shuffle to every song imaginable and just be weird and at Atlantis, and I can't wait to do more fun times in the future. I love you guys.
Happy wedding day! Sadie says hi. We love you guys. Sorry we can't be there, but we wanted to say congratulations. Happy wedding day, and we hope it's the best. Excuse our nighttime cute realness right now.
You know we look good.
Yeah, we do. We wanted to tell you guys our favorite thing about you two is that whenever y'all are around, there are always laughs to be had. You never take life too seriously, and you're always having fun together, and we love that. So just wanted to say congratulations. We love y'all.
Congrats, guys.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, this is Grandma. And I just want to wish you the best of luck in your marriage. I hope you'll be very happy, as I have been in both of mine. Love you guys.
Soon we will walk amongst the humans. But until that day comes, we must remember the crows don't just have eyes. We also have wings. Caw! Caw! Listen to me, caw! The day will come when we're no longer social outcasts. I am but a tail feather away.
Hey, we're just over here needing a haircut, preferably on Instagram if at all possible. This has not looked this bad in a long time. So please come visit soon. Congratulations, y'all. I miss you both. I wish I were there. I wish we were all there. This is the most insane time ever, and we're all in the mud, and somehow it has me thinking about other times in life. When I was in the mud, and what I know to be true is, Stacy, we have been in the mud together, and when you get in it with somebody, you are linked inextricably, for better or worse, till death do you part. And it is a real joy as a friend and as a person who has walked through it with you and been really grateful to have you beside me in it, to see the two of you as partners and as friends, and now as husband and wife. And Neil, you live up to all of the expectations set for you early on when we learned the first fact about you, which was that you made spreadsheets of all of the movies that you wanted to see. And we knew that Stacy didn't love anything more than spreadsheets and movies. So I love you guys so much, and I miss you so much, and I'm so, so happy for you. And I'm celebrating you here all week long until further notice. And looking forward to celebrating you in person as soon as humanly possible. So cheers. I think this is longer than it was supposed to be. Too bad. I love y'all. Goodbye.
Okay, Julie, are you ready for the toast?
Hey, Josh. Yeah, absolutely.
Excellent. So, Stacy and Neil, we are so excited to celebrate your wedding this Saturday from afar online.
Yeah, I mean, I always thought you guys were so millennial, but this really takes the cake.
So, let's have a toast. To Stacy, my amazing little sister. You know, even though you're the youngest, you've always been the smartest person in the family, hands down. And even though I'm the oldest, I always look up to you.
And you're so adventurous too, Stacy. I mean, who else would move to rural Arkansas by themselves for 2 years? And then to Philly, to the big city, to meet their true love. And then just decide to stop by London for 6 weeks on the way and hang out with your crazy brother and his crazy wife.
And Stacy, you know, there's no culinary challenge that you would ever back down from. I mean, donut burgers for breakfast, anyone?
Oh God, I feel so nauseous just thinking about it. But anyway, Stacy, you are such a fun person and you're so thoughtful and you actually just have the best recommendations. Like Trello, totally life-changing. And to Neil, our newly minted brother-in-law, who's always pushing the limits of Instagram as we cheer him on a daily basis.
And Neil, you really hit the nail on the head at Christmas 2018 when we first met with the cheese gun and hammer pants. Those were awesome. And that disturbing deep dive into the family photo archive cracked me up. And it seems like you crack each other up. And one thing that we found since being married is that making each other laugh is one of the most important things. I make Julie laugh all the time.
Right, so anyway, here's a toast to the happy couple. We really wish that we were there with you guys, and we love you guys, and hope that you have the most amazing day.
And we're looking forward to celebrating with you in person next year and having some of that awesome wedding cake.
I'm not that bothered by wedding cake, but I do love champagne, so cheers! Happy wedding day! Congratulations!
Congratulations to Stacy and Neil! You guys are the best.
Oh, we're supposed to drink. Wait. Bye.
Bye.
Happy wedding day.
Happy wedding day.
Say hi.
Happy wedding day, Actor.
Hey, Neil and Stacy.
Hey, guys. We are super sad that we're not going to be able to celebrate your wedding with you guys. But we look forward to doing it at a later date, and we love seeing you guys on social media, and we can see that you guys are obviously madly in love, and we couldn't be happy.
Happy wedding day, or close to wedding day, Stacy and Neil. I'm sorry you can't be with all your friends and family, but I'm hoping that this will be a fun way to celebrate with from a distance. So I've been asked to share my favorite thing about Stacy, and that is her boundless sense of adventure in the kitchen. As a neighbor in Helena, I got to be the beneficiary of her many, many explorations into baking, I think all of which were successful. I especially love the memory of sitting in her apartment at Beechwood, having a conversation with her and having her stop and run to the oven and spray down her rustic French, crusty French loaves with water. I don't even know what that was about, but it was something scientific and it worked and they were amazing. And I knew things were special when she came through Memphis and said, I'm bringing this guy. And we are like on a special food tour of the US basically. I mean, I think that wasn't the whole reason for driving, but it was definitely a big part. And so it was clear to me that Stacy had found somebody with as deep an appreciation of delicious and wonderful food and the experience of making and eating delicious food. So I hope you guys have something really delicious today, and I hope you have a delicious future. And my cat says hello.
Hi, happy wedding day.
Hey y'all, I have two favorite things about Stacy and Neil. One, spreadsheets. Two, just how much they really stink and like each other.
Hey, Stacy and Neil.
We are so happy for you guys. Congratulations on your big day. We're so sad that Corona is ruining all of our lives so that we can't be there to celebrate with you, but I'm sure it'll still be a magical, amazing day and one to remember for you guys. We are so happy for you, and we cannot wait for this mess of a pandemic to be over so that we can have a huge party and celebrate you guys properly the way that you deserve and that your love deserves. We love you, and we can't wait to see you guys soon as a married couple.
Congrats.
Bye.
Dear Stacy and Neil, I'm sorry to say that on this, your big day, we are so far away. A virtual wedding is a modern event. I hope you enjoy the gift I've not sent. So here is my video presence instead, to send my best wishes as you are wed. Sheltering in place, I send you my love. Please don't forget to wear masks and gloves.